Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back once again to our beautiful shooting range here in Baku, Azerbaijan. We're reaching the latter part of the afternoon. The range and surrounding area drenched in a beautiful setting sun. It's around 5:45 local time, and an amazing lineup of athletes are being assembled for our Skeet women's final here on day six. Very shortly, I'll hand over to our field of play announcer, Daniel Potts, as he tells the crowds here all about the very talented athletes that have made it into this afternoon's final.
Women's event will now begin. It is my absolute pleasure to present to you today's finalists. At position number one, representing France, making her first appearance in the final six of a World Cup and Junior World Championship silver medalist in Belgrade, Lucy Anastasiou.
So Lucy Anastasiou, first time in a final round, representing France at 23 years of age. A very, very exciting day for her and her team.
Representing the United States of America, World Cup gold medalist in Acapulco, and Continental American champion 2 years ago, Amber English.
So Amber English from the USA, ranked 15th in the world, and it's been 6 years since her last World Cup medal.
Number three, representing Italy, Olympic champion in Beijing, four times World Cup gold medalist, four times European champion. She took the bronze at the European Games right here in Baku, Chiara Cainero.
So Chiara Cainero, very, very experienced, the most experienced athlete out there on the range today.
World Cup silver medalist in Maribor 5 years ago, Paniota Andreu.
Paniota Andreu, the youngest athlete in this afternoon's final.
Position number five.
Previously a World Cup
Italy,
silver medalist.
World Cup silver medalist 2 years ago, and World Championship silver medalist in Lima, Simona Scaghetti.
So Simona Scaghetti, no stranger to a final, silver medalist, but never a World Cup gold medalist.
Number six, representing the Russian Federation. She placed fourth in Beijing World Cup 2 years ago, Anastasia Krakmalova.
Anastasia Krakmalova, 30 years of age, and it's her first final in 2 years, and a great time to do it. So a nice varied lineup of athletes, and joining me on commentary for this brilliant final, I'm very happy to say, all the way from Australia, she's been participating in her first World Cup, just 16 years of age, so narrowly missed out on this final, which is an incredible achievement. Thank you for joining me. It's Ashlyn Jones.
It's a pleasure to be here.
You did incredibly well. We were following your action throughout qualification, and just one target separating you and these ladies that made it to the final. That must have been frustrating at the time.
Oh, a little bit. I mean, I suppose one target, it's going to happen. Like, they had a few shooters in a shoot-off for the spots in the final, so...
Yeah, it's been a very, very close run thing, and well, all I can say, even you know, finishing just outside of the top six, is congratulations. Your very first World Cup, just before we
Thank
see
you.
The first shots. Have you enjoyed it so far?
Yeah, it's been great. Lovely weather, amazing range, everything.
You've ducked out of Australian winter to come and get some sun in Azerbaijan. So the first of our four stations that our athletes will see. Two pairs on each. And we have the first drop target of the final. I asked you before we started if there's any that present a kind of a particular problem, and you say, is it that reverse pair that's always the tricky one for athletes?
It tends to be. I suppose some people have their favourite targets, and I suppose there'd be some out there that love the reverse pairs. I know I quite like them, but it is one of those targets that we don't shoot in the round, so you don't shoot it all day, and then if you make a final, suddenly you got to shoot it.
Well, Amber English making a light work of her first two pairs. They've had a little bit of time between the end of qualification and the start of this final, over an hour or so. Another missed target there for Carnero. So perhaps this first station, a chance to get back in the shooting rhythm after qualification.
Yeah, I was surprised there was quite a bit of a wait between the end of qualification rounds and start of the final.
As a shooter, would you be more inclined to want to get straight on if you made it through, if you've done qualification, do you want to just keep that momentum going?
Yeah, probably. I mean, a bit of a break, like a mental break and physical break is good. But you got to be able to stay focused, like, for the time that you're not shooting, so that you're ready to go when you need to.
So another miss on the final reverse pair there for Andreu. So only one athlete making the perfect start, Amber English. Of course, we still have quite a way to go, three more stations, so all is not lost. Good start for Simona Scott-Getty. Excellent, perfect start. She rightly earns a round of applause from the crowd here. So the last of our athletes, Kokmelova, to shoot on the first station. See whether she can join the other two athletes that have made a perfect start. Quite the opposite. missing the reverse pair there. So I mean, there's still quite a way to go, even for Anastasia, who missed the pair there. And just a quick word on the conditions. It's lovely and warm. When we started the week, it was quite a bit more blustery. In qualifications, how did you find the weather for yourself?
Well, I've heard that Baku means wind city or something.
That's right, yeah.
So it must be known for its wind. But it's been pretty good. The targets haven't been as affected, like, as events that I've been to in the past. But we had a little bit of rain the other day, which was quite surprising.
Yeah, I took us by surprise as well. We had to run for cover. We're very lucky in our commentary position. We've got a front row seat on the left-hand side of the field of play, but we were reduced to running into the technical bunker so that we didn't get soaked. So this is the second station, station number four on the range. And Anastasia with a good score, no misses, four hits. Amber English looking to continue a perfect start to this final. She does. First athlete from the USA team to make it to the final round. So I know her colleagues and her coaches will be looking for a chance to get up on the podium. But a first miss for Amber English.
Oh.
For some of these guys, a chance, I guess, to stake a claim before the run-up to the Olympic Games. It's the last World Cup before the Olympics, although, as we've seen all week, quite a few squads have chosen to alternate, to not bring Olympic team members, which seems interesting. We kind of were discussing whether that was a good plan or not. Australia, you say that you've brought your squad.
Yeah, we've brought our Olympic team to this event.
So it's Andreu, the youngest athlete in this final. An excellent second station for her. She does have a World Cup final round experience, silver medalist in Maribor in 2011, which is incredible considering that she's just 20 years of age. So the only other athlete making a perfect start was Scott-Getty, and she misses one of that first pair on station number four. Will she have better luck with the reverse? Yes, she does. So far, Anastasia Korokmalova, she had those two misses on the first station.
That was a good recovery with that pair.
Yeah, makes light work of those. That must be very important to kind of bounce back as quickly as possible.
Yeah, definitely. You can't let anything get to you. So much can change in the space of, like, a pair. events won or lost, really.
Yeah, very true. There's with this this amount of quality athletes out there, you don't get too many chances to claw you know, points back, I imagine.
No, you just got to keep fighting the whole way.
And it must be quite a long wait. You missed a pair. You then have to wait for the whole rest of the field to go before you and make sure that, like you say, what you just clear that from your mind and focus on the next station.
Yeah, exactly that.
So still very close. Look at that, in fact. Five of our athletes all tied with seven targets. And just so at the moment, you know, two targets separating sixth, which would be an elimination spot and a gold medal place. It's amazing, really.
Mm.
It's not surprising, though, I suppose, if we had a shoot-off to decide who would make it into the final. So it's a very close field. So a second miss for Anastasio from France. Can Amber English pick back up where she started this final? One drop target on the second station. Wind seems to be calm on the field of play. The sun is setting though. I mean, when you were excellent shooting there, when you were in qualification, how was the visibility for you on this range?
Yeah, it was great. I love shooting here. Like, the sun is really bright and it just lights up the targets, really. It's a great background.
Yeah, they've done amazing work here, and visibility seems to be pretty incredible with a kind of perfect
it's
unbroken
very,
lines.
It's very uniform, really.
Oh.
So a good recovery there from Chiara Cainero. She missed the first target, but took all three following that. So she keeps in touch.
There's a pair.
Yeah, this is a missed pair. So this station seems to be causing quite a few problems. Does this rank with one of the harder ones, or is this just specific to the shooter, whether you have difficulty?
I would say probably more specific to the shooter, because, I mean, it's one of the ones you shoot in the round, apart from the reverse pair. So just like three and four, really.
It's got Getty, another athlete with World Cup final round experience. She's ranked 26th in the world at the moment. She does have a silver medal to her name, although never a gold. She's been up and around there before, but it's been 2 years, so she'll be very keen to use this opportunity to get into that gold medal final, although it's another drop target for her there.
Still sitting very close at the moment.
Yeah, it's unbelievably close. If Rakhmalova can take these, she'll still be in a relatively good position.
Nicely shot.
Great round. Well, she's keeping herself in touch. She's now not the only athlete with two misses. And Miss Vondreo on that station means that she is now tied for fifth position. So Amber English out in front with only a single drop target, 11 in total. And then our other three athletes tied for second place at the moment, Anastasio, Cagnero, Scoghetti, and then two athletes in fifth. So a little bit more separation, but hardly what you'd call much breathing room at the top for our top athlete.
No, definitely not.
Would you be paying much attention to the scoreboard, to anybody else that's around you, or is the idea to just focus on your own game?
I think at the end of the day, for me, it works best just to focus on what I'm doing, because I mean, you can't really control what the other people are doing. So if you just do your own thing and then see what happens, really.
I'm sure your coach would be very pleased to hear you say that. That's what we hear coaches saying. Ignore everybody else. But I'm sure that's easier said than done.
Yeah.
A good recovery there. First, a miss on the first target, and he takes the other three. Anastasio. We get a real close-up view of Station 4 of our athletes preparing. Amber English has made a great, great start to this final. She just chipped that last one. The referee on our side, he sort of twinged at his flag, but we could see it was definitely a hit, so
yeah.
Great work. That takes her into first position. She's shooting with a great amount of confidence. Ranked 15, just 26 years of age.
She shot very well in qualification too.
Yeah, she had a fantastic round, absolutely right. So she'll be pleased. Coach Todd Graves expects big things, as all these guys do. So I think there's going to be quite a fight for the medals in this final. Throws the empty shells down. She'll be disappointed with that. Can she bounce back? So that could prove costly. As we said, she's Andrea is the youngest athlete in this final, and that might just prove a little bit too costly for her to bounce back from. But we'll see. There is still a whole few more shots to go.
If she hits this pair, she'll win a shoot. Not quite.
She took one, but not the other. Yeah, you're absolutely right. She needed that to get herself into that shoot-off position. And another drop target for Krakmalova. Means that I think she'll retain sixth place. She never really recovered from that dropped pair, even though she bounced back personally. The rest of the field kept on trugging on. And so that means that we have had our...
No shoot-offs.
16 semi-final targets. No, absolutely. It looked like we were destined for a shoot-off. But the field opened up, so moving down into sixth place with a disappointing final station. Andreo Panayota from Cyprus. Fifth place from the Russian Federation. Anastasia Krakmalova. And our two athletes in the bronze medal final, from Lucy Anastasio from France, Simona Scorghetti from Italy, both tied with 13 targets each. And a really brilliant final from Amber English. Saw her go straight into our gold medal matchup, along with Chiara Cainero. So
they both worked hard for that one.
Yeah, absolutely. Amber will be feeling pretty confident, I would imagine. That's, like you say, a strong qualification and a real strong semi-final.
Yeah.
So they'll just change over, get ready for our bronze medal matchup. As we say, Amber English and Chiara Cainero going straight into our gold medal. For the two that are in the bronze medal match, for Anastasio from France, 23 years of age, first time in a final round, so you'd have to say already she'll be very pleased with that performance. Previous best was a ninth place in Gabala in 2015, so a chance to really improve on that. And for Simona Scorghetti, experienced shooter, 26th ranking in the world, as I said, never a gold medal. She does have a World Cup silver medal to her name, but it's been a couple of years before that. A previous best was a fourth place in Granada in 2013, and the bronze medal final, of course, takes on extra kind of pressure and poignancy, because these athletes do not want to leave in fourth.
No, it's medal or no medal, pretty much.
Yeah, exactly. For the guys that are now relaxing, waiting for their gold and silver medal matchup, they know they're going to leave with something, but for one of these, there's still the chance they could go home empty-handed.
Yeah.
So you mentioned that they only see that reverse pair on the in the final round. They've had a chance to see it once. So
yeah.
By rights, they should be kind of relaxing or into the final. But I imagine as well, does fatigue take a part of this? You've been shooting all day, kind of mentally and or physically.
I suppose it would have to a little bit. I mean, it is probably 6 o'clock now, so it's been a long day for the shooters.
So this should be an excellent contest. It's always wonderful to see athletes that are making their first appearance in the final round and pushing on into these medal matches.
Yeah.
It's Anastasio that will step up first. Nice, confident start. Excellent. It's an ideal start. It must be important to get those first four under your belt in a nice, confident fashion.
I think it does help with your confidence for the rest of the final, for sure.
And do you, I mean, I mentioned at the top, you're joining the, stepping up to World Cup level at what is, you know, a very, very young age. But do you, before you came here to this World Cup event, do you run finals style events so that you can get training in that sort of environment?
Yeah, there's I'll train at home, train finals and that sort of thing, but I suppose it's not the same as competition. But we do have several events in Australia throughout the year where I get final experience and that sort of thing. I've shot in the Junior Cup last year. I made the final. That was my first international comp, and that was definitely an experience for me.
A learning curve of dealing with that kind of stuff. Yeah. So the first station, perfect scores for both of our athletes. But not to be on the second station. Miss the second target for Lucy Anastasio. See if she can respond to that. She can with the first of the reverse, but not the second. So two misses station on the second station, so that could potentially prove costly. Can Simona Scocchetti take advantage of that? She certainly makes good use of the first two targets. Can she continue her perfect run in this bronze medal final? No, she can't. The last one just getting away from her. Do you notice anything different with their, you know, with the timing of these, and for example for yourself, when you're looking at the first pair and the reverse pair, is there anything you can do to adjust your timing to make sure that you, for instance, you definitely take one, or you take a risk on waiting on the other, or are you just about consistency for the whole pair?
Probably consistency, yeah. I mean, I think that's the best way to get the results, consistency, timing and that sort of thing. And it just becomes like muscle memory, really.
Yeah, of course, the advantage of Skeet is you know the scheme, you know what's going to be coming.
Yeah.
So that there aren't other many other challenges, but you can try and imprint, I suppose, that timing into your game.
Yeah.
So a great third station from Anastasio.
She fought back strongly with that.
Yeah, and that's hugely important as it stands. This present moment in time, she is only one target behind. So this is by no means done and dusted, that's for sure.
No.
And there we go.
Even.
Yep, talked it up. We are now back to even. So after those first 12 targets, two misses from each of them means that it's effectively like the slate has been wiped clean for the last station. It's absolutely fantastic. Very, very close. Both of them will be very hungry for this World Cup bronze medal. Very confident opening pair, Anastasio. She had that slight slip on the second station, but she'll be looking to put that behind her and finish with a perfect four here, which she does. Yeah. Brilliant. That's a great amount of focus to the very end.
Pressure's on now.
Yes. So it's back over to you, Simona. She's done it before. She knows what it takes. But nothing short of perfection at this station will be enough for her to remain in this bronze medal final. Two more targets. And she takes them. Yeah, that's great. As you say, that's a pressure moment right there.
Yep.
So we predicted that there may need to be a shoot-off in the semi-final. It wasn't the case, but an extremely close bronze medal final means that we will go on to shoot-off. So they're both taking a moment. Sometimes they literally run straight into the next round. They're just topping up on some ammunition and having a little bit of a drink.
Yeah. It's definitely warm out here. It's important to keep fluids up.
Yeah. And I mean, you know, we've had the, I take that back. I've had the luxury of being out here for a short amount of time. You know exactly what it's been like out here all day. And, you know, your qualification rounds are running right through the hottest part of the day, really.
Yeah.
It must be exhausting.
Yeah, no, it gets pretty tiring. It's good they have a few shade things around. You can stand between stations and that sort of thing. But, like, taking a water bottle out during the round, that's definitely helped.
It must help for mental fatigue as well. Keep yourself hydrated.
Yeah. Standing out in the sun all day is not going to do the world of good.
Well, at least the British shooters have got an excuse, but it rains all the time at home. You're used to the sun.
Yeah.
So, first pair of our shoot-off is confidently taken down by Anastasiou. She turns away from the field of play. It's over to Scocchetti. And again, she confidently takes them down. So they both get the original pair, then they will both receive the reverse pair. She seems to have a very intense style.
Yeah, no, I reffed her, and I think her last round, yeah, she looks like she works very hard. Everybody has a different style of shooting. Some people are very relaxed, some people are very intense and into it. It all depends on the shooter.
So Simona is very well supported this afternoon from the rest of the Italian shotgun shooting team and, in fact, other members of the audience that are here. They're impressed with that first round. They know the pressure is on. Many of them will have been out there in either a similar discipline or the same, so they know how intense this can be. And up steps Lucy Anastasiou. Looking for a bronze medal in her first World Cup final round. And Scocchetti answers. Do you feel there's any advantage or disadvantage with being either the first shooter in a shoot-off or being the second shooter?
Some people prefer going second. I would probably rather first, because I suppose you can sort of lead the way and it puts pressure on the second shooter.
Oh, again, she just took a chip out the back of that one, but they all count. Yeah, because it seems as though the second shooter is under more pressure from where we're sat. You know, I'm imagining you're under pressure wherever you are in a shoot-off. Confidently taken. Big puffs of powder coming out of those clays. So we've had eight and nothing but green on the scoreboards in front of us. A great, great shoot-off so far. Neither of them budging an inch. There is someone from the French team who's grabbing a little bit of that shade that we were talking about next to the announcing position. So Lucy Anastasio. Oh. It's the call.
Oh.
And there is the first dropped target. She looks very, very disappointed as she steps away. And it's now over to Simona Scocchetti. Chance to win her first medal in 2 years, which she does. Fantastic.
Big cheers from the Italians.
Yeah, they're up on their feet. And it's a massive, massive relief for her. That was a great bronze medal final and a wonderful shoot-off as well. Effectively, almost a double final.
Yeah, almost.
To decide it. And massive congratulations, a big embrace. From one of the guys that was jumping around in the stands. So congratulations, and it must be said, a fourth place finish for Lucy Anastasio. She'll be no doubt disappointed in this present moment in time.
But
that's a great achievement.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah, and the first time in the final round. So we have our bronze medalist after a very intense finals match. And if those guys were that close, then goodness knows what's going to happen now, because there was almost nothing to choose between these two in the final round.
Yeah. This could be a good gold medal match.
Yeah, absolutely. Amber English from the USA, 26 years of age. She's previously a bronze medalist, so however this final goes down, she'll be improving on her personal best, which I'm sure she'll be thrilled about, but now she'll have her eyes trained on that gold medal. And in fact, it was 6 years since she picked up bronze. But quite the competitor she has to go through in Chiara Caniero. A 12-time World Cup gold medalist, four of them gold. And her last was in Granada in 2013. And silver medal last year in Alain. So
she's been shooting for a long time, a lot of experience.
Yeah, and incredible. It seems not that many finals go by where we're not saying Caniero's name. He's amazing, and this will be important for her leading into the Olympic Games. She'll want to really make a statement here, I'd imagine.
Yeah. You know, it'd be good confidence going into the Games.
She of course took the gold in Beijing in the 2008 Beijing Games, but took fifth place in London 2012. So she made it to the final, but no medal. And on the first station, a missed target for Amber English. She went almost the entire semi-final without missing one. So she'll be disappointed, but Caniero not able to take advantage, immediately dropping the first target. That'll be a relief for Amber, I would imagine.
Yeah, I'm not sure if she was really watching.
No, she took a long walk away from the field of play. So both of them with a slight hiccup, but evening themselves out. So no difference between them, three hits each, and both tied. Say the Italian team have already had a little bit to celebrate so far this week. The Team USA haven't even been in the finals, and they'll be pleased to see one of their competitors on the podium. But another miss.
Yeah, the Italians here are guaranteed two spots on the podium now.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's just a matter of which one.
A good recovery once again after dropping one of the initial pair. And Amber takes a long walk each time from the stations. It's a confidently hit. Here's a chance to take advantage. She can take both of these reverse targets.
Oh.
Chiara Caniero will get the lead. But she can't. Last one escapes her.
And puts them even again.
Yeah, it's back and forth. It's kind of tennis rules at the moment, score-wise. It makes for an exciting final. I'm sure it's nail-biting.
Oh, yeah.
Some of our coaches can't even bear to look. They're kind of staring down into clenched hands. Whilst you're waiting behind somebody that's shooting in a final round, you quite a lot see at times people just turn their back, they don't want to look at all. Others use it as an opportunity to try and
see where the target's going.
What's your preference?
I'll watch some of the targets, but I won't watch others. So, I mean, it sort of depends on the shooter, and a lot of the shooting technique is personal. But I find I like to know if the target, like if the high house is going flat or something, I like to be aware of that. But sometimes I don't sort of look
too intently.
Yeah.
So a perfect station from Amber English, and a single dropped target there from Caniero means this is an opportunity for the athlete from the USA to take advantage. And in fact, it's two dropped targets. So a costly station there.
This opens it right up.
Yeah, absolutely. In what has been extremely close, neck and neck, literally the entire final, it means that coming back around to our final station, that Amber English from the USA has a two-target advantage. The Italian contingent that were up on their feet before are looking decidedly more nervous now. I'm sure there'll be a big eruption from then if you can overhaul this. So pretty simple. If Amber English takes all her targets, she takes home a gold medal.
She's only got to hit one of these and she's got it.
Fantastic.
Awesome finish.
Yeah, what a great finish. She had two misses quite close together, but the back end of that final was absolutely impeccable from Amber English. And can Caniero finish on a high with a perfect final station? She can. It's not enough to secure gold medal. That goes to Amber English from the United States of America. Congratulations to her, and a silver medal and a second medal in this final for Italy, for Chiara Caniero. So there'll be big smiles in the USA camp. All of our medalists now making their way back onto the field, and after a very, very close start to that gold medal final, it is Amber English that wins with a two-target advantage. Well, a fantastic final round. We should have expected it to be so close after the how close qualification was,
yeah.
But great athletes and a great final round.
Yeah.
Well, all it leaves me to do is to say that we've had an absolutely fantastic final, another great day here in Baku. I'd like to say a massive thank you to Ashlyn Jones. Just 16 years of age, you appeared at your first World Cup, and then at your first World Cup, you also make your commentary debut
yeah.
as well.
Doesn't get much better than that.
you've been absolutely fantastic. I'm sure next time I'm going to be here talking about you in the final round.
That would be good.
We've had a wonderful day, brilliant shooting. But for now, from me, Jack J, and the entire ISSF TV team, from everybody here in Baku, it's thank you and goodbye.
Just on the other side of the stands here, and you're really brilliant. So we hope to see you there. Please come show your support for the well-deserved medal winners, and we'll see you there.
Bravi ragazzi, bravi.
The bronze medal, yes.
representing Italy goes to Simona Scaghetti. Goes to Chiara Cairo.
Le mamme più forte del mondo.
Chiara. Chiara.
And the gold medal representing the United States of America goes to Amber English. Anthem of the United States of America. Baku World Cup, but once again, please put your hands together for your medal winners.